In this video, I'm going to show how to create a 3D model from the basic thing. So I'm just going to open a new model here. And as we discussed in previous video, how to create the grid system and number of stories, we are going to use that grid system again. So I'm going to use the built-in settings and click on OK. And I'm just going for uniform grid spacing, and I want to give number of grid lines in X direction as something around 5. And number of grid lines in y direction is 4, and spacing in x direction is 4 meters, and in y direction I want to give it as 3 meters. Okay, and the number of stories is, I'm going to take it as something around 6, and typical story height I'm going to take it as 3.2 meters, and the bottom story height is 3 meters. Okay, and if you want to specify different height for the floors, different heights for the different floors, then you can click on custom story data and you can click on edit story data and you can give different heights here. Okay, so at present let us consider the similar stories. I mean, I'm going to give the typical story height as same here and click on OK. So here I'm going to create the properties again with the material sections. So in previous videos, we have seen how to create the material and then we have created the properties. But in this video, I'm going to generate the materials in the property panel, okay, in the property window by using the property window. I'm just going for define and directly go for the section properties and select the frame sections. And I'm going to click on add new properties. And before that, if you want to delete these all multiple properties, you can delete. So you can click on delete multiple properties. I don't require these all the things. So just you can select all the things by using the shift N. And you can click on delete selected frames. So there are two more here and delete them. So delete selected frames. Okay. So click on OK to close this window and click on add new property. So just select the rectangular section and I'm going to give the property name as something around beam, which is of 300 x 230 width. Okay. And the material used is M20 grade or M25 grade. So here we can't see the concrete grade here. So I'm just going to create the concrete grade or concrete material by using this option here, add material. Okay. So instead of creating before this, I'm going to use this option and it will be proceeded for define materials window. It will be forwarded for this window and click on add new material. And under region, you have to select the India and the material type will be concrete here. And the standard is Indian standard and the grade, whatever the grade you want to assign there. So for example, I'm going to consider M25 grade and click on OK. And if you want to change this, all the things you can change. At present, I'm going to take the same values, I mean the default properties. So just click on OK. And again, click on add new material and I want to apply the rebar also. Just click on rebar and select the required grade there. So HYSD 415. So click on OK. Say for example, if you want to apply 500 grade for normal steel bars and stirrups, so you want to provide 415, you have to create two grades. Okay. So at present for this basic model, I'm going to select 415 and click on OK. And again, just click on OK to close this window. So we have created the required materials and click on OK to close this window again and click on material option and select the M25 grade for the rectangular cross section. Okay. And we have to define the section dimensions. So dimensions are depth is 300 mm and width is 230 mm. Okay. And you can click on reinforcement option like modify or show rebar and you can edit the reinforcement data here. So the design type is beam here, beam only, and cover to longitudinal rebar group. Okay, so whatever the cover you want to provide there. So the basic cover is 30 mm for the beam and the rebar material, longitudinal bars and tie bars. As I said, if you want to define two grades, you can define and you can select from the list here. Okay, since I have defined only one thing, you can just select that grade. Okay. If you want to define another grade of steel, simply you can click and the same procedure can be followed here. Okay. So going for confinement bars, just click on here and you can just select the HYSD bars and you can provide other details for the ductile beam. So let us skip this here. So click on OK and click on OK. So one material has been created, I mean one property has been created. If you want to make another copy of this, so simply click on add copy of property. So I'm just going to change this one to column. So column, let us take something like 450 x 450. And the sections are 450 mm depth as well as width is also 450. And here we need to change the reinforcement to column design. Okay. So column and longitudinal bars is HYST and confinement bars is also HYST 415. Since we have kept copy, all these properties will be repeated. In case if you are selecting the new property option, then we have to define each and everything. Okay. And the reinforcement configuration, whether you want to provide normal square type stirrups, then you can go for rectangular. Okay, if you want to provide spiral or like circular type, then you can choose the circular option here. Okay, and the confinement bars obviously will be ties. If you are selecting the circular, then you can choose either ties or the spirals here. Okay, so right now I'm going to choose the rectangular cross section, I mean rectangular reinforcement. And checkout design, so reinforcement to be checked or reinforcement to be designed. So for this model, I'm going to design. So let it be reinforcement to be designed and longitudinal bars and confinement bars details has to be provided here. So clear cover for confinement bars, minimum cover is 40 mm. If you want to increase, you can increase according to the environment over there, the location of the structure. And number of bars along the three direction face and second direction face, you can just define the number of longitudinal bars you require and the longitudinal bar size and area. Okay, so actually these things we can edit in designing also. So let it be like this and click on okay. Similarly, you can edit the confinement bars also. Okay, so after defining all these things, so click on okay and click on okay to close this window. And if you want to create another beam, say for example, I want to provide intermediate beams, okay, with different cross section. So in that case, I can go for another copy here, add copy of material. And the property name would be beam 230 x 230, okay. So let it be 230 x 230. And the section dimensions are depth is also 230, width is also 230. We have to change the reinforcement again to beam. Okay. So since we have kept the copy of beam, the properties will be same here. So let us click on OK and OK here. So we have created three frame sections. Okay. The sections required to create the beams and columns, which is a frame structure. And as well as I want to define the slabs also. Okay. So in order to create the slab, again we are going for define and we have to go for the section properties and we have to select the slab sections. Okay. So click on slab sections and you are going to get the default property. So let us delete the property. Okay. So let us delete the existing property and this is a default one. Now I want to add a new property and I want to name it as just a slab. Okay, slab of, let us take something around 250 mm. Okay, and the slab material is M25. And if you want to provide different grade for this slab, you can click on this option and you can recreate the concrete material over there. And the property type is slab and the thickness I'm going to consider is 250 mm. And here make sure that the modeling type is shell thin. Okay, for slabs we are going to use this option. Okay, and just click on OK. And click on OK to close this window. Now there is already an existing grid layer. I mean grid system is there. Now we have to define the beams, columns and slabs for this. So make sure that you are working. I mean you are going to assign the beams and columns for all the stories. Okay. So make sure that you are selecting the similar stories option here. So click on this and just go for similar stories option. And now I want to provide the beams, columns as well as slabs. Okay, so in order to do that, just go for draw and you can go for draw beam or column and you can just select the quick draw beams or quick draw columns here. Okay, so same these options are available at left side also. You can just choose the icons here, anything is okay. So I'm just going for draw beam or column and just I'm going to select quick draw beams. And you have to be careful with the selection of this property bar here. Okay. And whatever property you need to assign for the beam. So the property I'm going to assign for external beam is 300 by 230. Okay. Now simply you can just highlight like this. Okay, if you want to define the external beams, so simply you can just highlight, or you can use control to hold the all the different sections. Okay, right now I have used drag and drop method here, and similarly I want to provide internal beams. Okay, so let us take these as beam 300 by 230 only. So just select this one. You can hold control button and select the multiple objects like this, or else you can just drag it like this. Okay, now I want to provide intermediate or like another section beams here for intermediate beams. I'm going for beams 230 by 230 and just select this grid lines, and automatically the beams will be placed on those grid lines. Okay, you can see that beams has been placed for all the stories here except the base floor. So since I want to make it open, and for all the other floors I want to define the beams over there. Okay, the next thing is I want to draw the column. So just go for draw beams or column, and just go for quick draw columns, and make sure that you are selecting the correct property there, that is column 450 by 450. So let us consider all columns are same for this model, and just you can apply the columns for all the grid intersections. Okay, and the next thing is I want to provide the slab. So in order to provide the slab, just go for draw, and you can go for draw floor or wall objects. Either manually you can draw, as I explained in other videos, okay, or else you can go for quick draw floor. So this will be applied only when the grid system is available. If grid system is off, we can't work on this. So how to turn off the grid? You can go for control D. So just you can give the command as control plus D. So control D to turn off the grid system. Okay. Or else you can just go for view, and you can turn off the grid here. Okay. Set grid system visibility. Control D is the shortcut key. Okay, so let us apply the slab. Now you can see that the outline has been slightly highlighted. Okay, now just click on that, and automatically we are able to create the slabs like this. Okay, so you can provide number of slabs over there. So in this way we have created the framed structure and the floors also. And the next one, so let me undo this. So I have assigned slab other property. So I'm just going for draw, and go for draw wall or floor beams and quick draw. So just select the property as slab here. Just go for the slab 250 mm and just define the slabs for all the sections there, all the frames. So either you can just choose like this, or you can just drag hold the structure there, and we got the 3D structure. And the next step is to apply the support conditions for this. So in order to apply the support conditions, we need to go for the plan view and just select the base, click on apply, and click on OK. So here we need to assign the support for only base of the column, right? No need to provide the support for other points. So make sure that you are just selecting the one story option. Okay, for example, if you are selecting all stories or similar stories, what happens is the supports will be assigned for all the floors. But right now I require supports for only bottom base floor or the endpoints of the column. Okay, now I'm just going to select all the joints. You can see that in 3D all the joints has been highlighted there, and then go for assign, and you can go for joint option, and then go for restrictions, and you can assign the fixed support. Click on apply and click on OK. Fine. So you can see that the supports has been assigned. Okay, you can just see the difference. Previously it was some other shape. After assigning the supports, it has been changed to this one. Okay, so, and one more thing, if you want to get the render view, of course we can see this 3D solid view in the current window here, that is 3D window. So in order to see the 3D, you can simply go for extruded view, and you can see the 3D transparent view here. If you want to turn off the transparent view, you can just turn off the transparency for frame as well as shell in this option here, transparency toggle. Okay, so if you want to see the rendered system or rendered figure of this, so just turn off the extruded model and let it be normal line mode, and you can go for view option, and here you are going to have the show rendered view. Okay, just go for the 3D window, and then we are going for view, and click on show render view here, and automatically a certain window will be open, separate window will be open like 3D render view, and we are going to get the 3D object like this. Okay, so just you can scroll it, I mean you can use your mouse to rotate the screen like this. Okay, and in upcoming videos we'll see how to expand the surface, I mean how to expand the slab surface over there. So in this video we have discussed about how to create different sections and how to generate the 3D model, and we have assigned the supports and we have seen the render view also. In this